Hello and welcome back to Spadaro Farm. Today's a good day. We finally got the last components for our rain system. It came in the mail. So we have our leaf eater and then we have our first flush system, which are going to be pretty cool because I've been excited to get this thing set up and working, start collecting water. In the video above, we also set up the connection between the two IBC totes. So now all that's left is to give us a draining system to make sure that you're not getting any of the bird poop from your roof or the loose shingle chemicals. And we're going to take care of all that and show you easily how to set it up and go through part by part. And here we go. What you have here are all the components that you're going to buy within this package, and it's everything that you need for your first flush system. Let's put it all together. Put in, I chose the 0.5. It's very, very tiny, so it's gonna have a slow drip. We'll start with that just to see how it goes. And what you're gonna do is insert in the base your filter down through, put your cap on and screw tight. I'm going to take the ball. It's going to get stuck here like this. And there you have it. It's very simple setup. So all that's left is I'm going to take the PVC primer and cement and make sure the ball's in. And I will cap off the end here so that this is nice and secure, and the same for the top. However, what I want to go over is the way that this works. You see this little nipple on the bottom. So it's gonna rain and it's gonna come in through the top. And it's gonna enter in, it's gonna start filling up, and all the nasty stuff from your roof is gonna go in here, and it's going to sit at the bottom. But there is the filter in there, so it's not gonna block the outlet. And what's gonna happen is once the water goes and fills up that first flush, the ball on top will actually stop the water from going through and the debris. So it will allow the water to then route into your tank. So this is going to be the PVC connection to go outward towards the tank. And the good part about this version itself is I don't have to worry about after a big storm or something like that, I don't have to go out and empty this. It already is going to be emptied because this little spout will let out very minute amounts of water at an interval. It just keeps dripping like a very, very slow drip. Much less than if you have a little drip in your faucet in your house. Hopefully you don't have that either, but anyway. So let me put this together and then we'll go ahead and install it. So now that we have the first flush system ready and the leaf eater attached, we're just gonna mark out on the wall, put it there temporarily and get the proper height so then we can do the downspout into the IBC tote. So this piece now is gonna go on the top. Depending on what your downspout looks like, they have a bunch of cutouts, they can just pop out, and then that's going to be the width of your pipe. All right, so now that we have everything in a relatively the position that we are expecting it to be in long term, I'm going to add another bracket so that this isn't shimmying down while I figure out the PVC from the 3-inch connection down to the 2-inch into the IBC. All right, so let's do a quick recap of what we've done so far. We got the first flush system installed. And we're gonna top that off with the leaf eater to make sure that any of the larger debris is first coming down from the gutters is going to be kicked out. So anything like leaves and sticks, because they will get on the roof and come down into the IBC, which you don't want that creating any type of bacteria. So then the second system is actually the first flush, where that is going to collect all of those more small debris, like the chemicals that are in the bird poo that's coming down into the water. So once the water fills up, the ball will stop and cork that section and then allow the rest to flow through the output and into your IBC tote, keeping the clean rainwater stored for you. And then with the external wrapping so that you're not getting algae or anything in there. So that wraps up our first setup of our rain system, and the other videos that you can check out are how we connected the two IBC totes, and then the next step that we're going to be doing is connecting a full-on electric pump to this system so that we can move the water from here to about 200 feet over that way. So that's all. Thanks for watching.